Dow University Hospital has been designed in such a way that it caters for general masses and those people who are less affording and those who cannot afford medical treatment at a very high cost. The hospital is fully equipped, has got a fully equipped intensive care unit, operation theater, neonatal intensive care unit, and labor room. The hospital has all the facilities for patients with liver and GI diseases. We have facility for endoscopies, upper and lower GI, facilities for fibroscan, facility for radio frequency ablation, and all invasive procedure under one roof. This hospital is providing services to all the patients who are needy. The charges at this hospital are very, very economical, keeping in view the economic situation of the country. This hospital has a full-fledged radio diagnostic department, laboratory and diagnostic services, besides other facilities. And the charges of these diagnostic services are almost one-third of what the private hospitals are charging in the city. Similarly, the facilities for indoor patients, the charges are very economical and the services are up to the highest possible standards.
A 500-bed general hospital has recently been established under the banner of Dow University of Health Sciences, DUHS. The tertiary care Dow University Hospital, situated at the Ocha campus, was created to fill the widening gap between expensive private healthcare facilities and overworked public sector hospitals. Its vision is to provide to the salaried middle class healthcare second to none at a very affordable cost. It also serves a dual purpose as a teaching hospital to teach and train MBBS and postgraduate students of the Dow International Medical College. While the construction and establishment costs were borne by the government, the hospital is intended to be self-supporting. However, the emphasis is on merely covering operating costs, and therefore all its healthcare services are charged at minimum rates. The hospital has a 500-bed capacity, including 13 spacious general wards for males, females, and children. Private and semi-private rooms are also available at extremely modest charges. There is a fully functional operating theatre suite with excellent facilities for all kinds of surgical procedures, both elective as well as emergency. Surgeries carried out here include general, abdominal, chest, cardiac, orthopedic, urological, gynae and obstetrics, pediatric, eye, plastic, ENT and neurosurgery. It includes a 10-bed labor suite for obstetrical services. It also has a fully functional 12-bed ICU and surgical ICU, equipped with ventilator facilities available at very modest cost. A 10-bed neonatal ICU with ventilator facilities is also available. A new state-of-the-art theatre complex comprising 12 operating theatres for gynecological and general surgery and a 100-bed ICU with ventilators is in the completion stages. A liver transplant facility is also in the process of being set up. This state-of-the-art hospital is staffed by leading senior consultant physicians and surgeons in various areas of specialization and is fully equipped with the most modern equipments in all its various departments. The consultants are assisted by qualified, trained and experienced resident medical officers, nurses and paramedical staff who work round the clock on day and night shifts. All-inclusive health packages have been designed for inpatient care. These health packages, available at very modest rates, are not dependent on the number of days the patient remains admitted. Special welfare packages are offered for surgical procedures and operations, such as endoscopy at only 3,500 rupees, normal delivery at 5,000 rupees, C-section at 12,000 rupees, laparoscopic cholecystectomy at only 20,000 rupees, and appendix or hernia operations at only 7,000 rupees. No patient is ever refused treatment at the hospital, regardless of his or her financial conditions. Those who cannot afford even its extremely modest charges are admitted for treatment at a reduced rate or free of charge after their financial resources have been assessed and verified by a special committee. For the indigent, the hospital arranges finances through its own resources or its access to benevolent funds. The diagnostic facilities of the Dow University Hospital are second to none. The Dow Diagnostic Laboratory possesses the latest equipment and testing facilities for histopathology, molecular pathology, biochemistry, cytology, hematology, and other specialized tests. The fully functional Dow Diagnostic and Radiology Complex possesses state-of-the-art X-ray, ultrasound, mammography, echocardiography, color Doppler machine, fibroscan, CT scan, and MRI scan, and fluoroscopic equipment and other cutting-edge diagnostic models from General Electric of the USA. Both the laboratory and the radiology complex are staffed by highly qualified and experienced pathologists and technologists. The outpatient department OPD, which operates from 8:30 a.m. till 2 p.m., caters to about 500 patients daily, who are examined and treated by various specialists, including those of internal medicine, surgery, gynecology and obstetrics, maternal healthcare and pediatrics, neurology, gastroenterology, ENT, orthopedics, and ophthalmology. OPD patients pay only a nominal fee of 100 rupees per visit, which gives them access to the services of senior consultants. The same consultants are also available from 2 to 9 p.m. for executive clinics, where patients pay just 200 rupees per consultation. The OPD also has a dental department with 4 dental chairs and a fully functional physiotherapy department. The hospital also houses the National Institute of Liver and Gastrointestinal Diseases, NILGID, the first liver institute of Pakistan, which possesses the maximum diagnostic and treatment facilities for patients with liver diseases. Here, consultants are available round the clock. At its bleeding care unit, patients with acute upper and lower GI bleed are provided emergency treatment, including emergency blood transfusion. Band ligation is performed through an endoscopic procedure, and colonoscopy is also performed whenever required. The hospital has also installed Pakistan's first fibroscan machine, which provides clues to the liver condition without a liver biopsy. After emergency treatment, patients are kept for observation in a high dependency unit. A radio frequency ablation facility is also available to treat patients of liver cancer. Dow's National Institute of Diabetes and Endocrinology, which is a part of the hospital complex, serves the needs of patients, particularly the growing number of diabetic patients in Karachi. The institute also conducts training courses for postgraduates and family physicians. The institute building also houses the ophthalmology department, where patients receive the latest eye care treatment, especially for diabetic eye care. The major focus of the hospital is on preventive healthcare, and for this purpose, it has set up a very effective community health program. The hospital has its own well-stocked pharmacy department, which caters to the needs of both inpatients and outpatients. All medicines are provided to patients at discounted rates. Despite its very short history, the Dow University Hospital has already carved out a special niche for itself in the healthcare sector and has ambitious expansion plans.